عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم عليه تسليما كثيرا إلى يوم الدين ثم من مات. ابن القيم رحمه الله, he said in one of the beautiful statements about dua, that dua is a weapon, and a weapon is like, or the weapon is only as strong as the person who is using it. It is not merely the matter how sharp it is. If the weapon is perfect and free of faults, and the arm of the person who is using it is strong, and nothing is stopping him, then he can lay waste the enemy. And if any of these three features is lacking, then the effect will be lacking accordingly. One of the beautiful statements about the dua. So as a believer, as a Muslim, you have your weapon with you at all time. And what you need to do is to use your weapon as it should be, and to be a professional archer to hit the target, and that requires you to have or to acquire some of the qualities of the hunters or some of the qualities of the fishermen. And you need to be patient. If you don't get anything today, you can always try again tomorrow or the next day. Also, you need to focus on your target. You allow no obstructions or distractions. Also, to choose your time, to select your time carefully, as time has to be your prime concern. You can ask those hunters and they will tell you. And as we learn so many things in this world, we need to learn how to ask from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For example, if we would ask anything from any person in this world, especially if he is an important person, someone who comes from the higher tier society, then we would consider so many things. From the right time, to the right words, and so forth. So how about asking from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Consequently, there are some adab, or some sunnah, or some etiquettes should be observed, so our dua is offered in a proper manner. What are those adab? First of all, is when you raise your hand to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you need to praise Allah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, ليس أحد أحب إليه المدح من الله سبحانه وتعالى. There is no one who likes to be praised more than Allah does. Also, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, once he heard the person who was making dua during prayer, and he didn't glorify, he didn't praise Allah, nor invoke salawat on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he said to the person that this person he was too hasty, and he called him, and he said, if or when any one of you wants to make dua, then he should start with praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, should then send salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, should then ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for anything that he wishes. But how can we praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? There are five ways to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. First of all, you can praise Allah as he prays himself. You can go to the Quran, and this is the best way. You can go to the hadith or the sunnah. If you want to make a dua, you have to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with one of these five ways. The first one is to praise Allah as he praised himself. Second is to praise Allah as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam praised him. Of Allah's creation, no one surpassed him in knowing and appreciating him as he ought to be sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Thirdly, you can praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as the Sahaba, or as the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or as the pious predecessors. Number four, you can praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your own words, so long as these words don't contradict the Islamic belief, which is why it is highly emphasized to make dua with your own language. Make dua with your mother tongue language. You don't have to go and, no, I have to see, I have to memorize some du'as in Arabic or whatever. You can make your du'a with your own language, because that emanates from the heart. When you make the du'a, or when you praise Allah, with your own language, with your own words sometimes, this is comes from the heart, and this is going to be a powerful du'a. Number five, also one of the best way to praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is to praise Allah through his beautiful names. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلِلَّهِ أَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى فَادْعُوهُ بِهَا. To Allah belongs the most beautiful names or the finest things. So call him by that. Yet, in our world, we call some people with titles. Your Highness, Your Excellency, Sheikh, Mufti, Doctor, Teacher, whatever. And this is also from Deen. This is also from Deen. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, أَنزِلُ النَّاسَ مَنَزِلَهُمْ. That treat people according to their states. Or treat people according to their ranks. So it is also from Deen to call people with their titles. It's a part of respect. It's a part of reverence also. So it's also recommended in our Deen. What is the purpose of making dua? Or what is the purpose of praying five times a day? What is the purpose of religion? Why do we pray five times a day? Why do we go to Hajj? Why do you pay zakah? Why do you make dua? Why? Is to have connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is to build a relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I was reading one of the books. The author wasn't a Muslim. He said, if you have a stress, then you have to meditate. And this we have it in the Quran. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Don't they think deeply about the Quran? Don't they think deeply about the creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So the purpose, the main purpose of Deen is to build the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Praising Allah is one of the commendable acts a believer can perform. Secondly, to have your dua answered is to send salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and put in mind that a dua won't be accepted by Allah until you send salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. As it comes in the hadith, that the dua is kept until you send or invoke blessings upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the reason why we do that is because of the ayah of the verse of the Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, it's Allah's explicit injunction to the ummah when he said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَمَلَائِكَتَهُ يُصَلُّونَ عَلَى النَّبِيِّ يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا صَلُّوا عَلَيْهِ وَسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. That indeed Allah showers His blessings upon the Prophet and His angels. Pray for him. All believers invoke Allah's blessings upon the Prophet and salute him with worthy greetings of peace. So this is one of the virtues, is to have conformity with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sending His blessings. You're also invoking Allah's blessings on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But what does this signify? The hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to know the virtues of making salawat or sending salawat to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, من صلى عليه صلاة واحدة صلى الله عليه بها عشر ومن صلى عليه صلاة كتبت له عشر حسنات ومحيت عنه عشر سيئات ورفع عشر درجات. That whoever sends upon me blessings or invokes blessings upon me, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him 10 hasanat, 10 good rewards, and will erase from his record 10 bad rewards or 10 sins, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will erase him 10 degrees in status. In another narration, that وَمَا صَلَّى عَلَيْهِ صَلَاةً صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ بِهَا عَشْرًا. That whoever prays for blessings for me once, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless him for it 10 times. And the angel will bless him 70 times. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will remember you personally with your name, and if you are remembered by Allah, what greater gift could a believer desire? So making salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the cornerstone of any blessing. It also helps our dua to be accepted. It also casts away the anxiety, the worry, the concern. Also, it will be lightened, as it comes in the hadith of Ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu, once asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he told him, I invoke a lot of dua. So in what portion should I send salutations? In what portion should they make salawat upon you? Then he said, however much you want. Then he told him the fourth. He said, if you wish, should you increase the number, then it will be better for you. Then he told him the half. He said, if you wish, should you increase the number, then it will be better for you. Then Ubay ibn Ka'b radiallahu anhu said, instead of making dua for myself, I will just raise my hand
and sent salawat on you. Then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him that if you do so, then your wrongs will be pardoned and your worries will be freed from your worries. So this means that we have to send salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on our daily basis. And the simplest way to do that is after each salah. After each salah, 10 times, 20 times, Allahumma salli ala nabiyyina Muhammad. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam also said that inna aqrabakum minni majlisan yawm al-qiyamah akfarukum alayya salat. That those who will be closest to me in the day of judgment are those who oftenly send salawat on me. So instead of saying thank you Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam for the efforts you've done for us, thank you for everything, then we say Allahumma salli wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad. And we have to know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam acknowledged our existence, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam answers our greetings. Imagine on the day of judgment, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam will know you by your name. Why? Because you are sending him salawat every day. The malaika, they will say, so and so is saying salatu alayka Rasulullah. He sent the salawat on you. So and so is sending the salawat on you. So on the day of judgment, he will be knowing you. Imagine if somebody sends you a salam every day, even if you don't know him. How would you welcome him if you see him? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will welcome you with a great love in the day of judgment because you are sending him a lot of salawat. So instead of saying, thank you Rasulullah for everything, thank you for your concern about the ummah, his main concern sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was about the ummah. Even in his last moments in this dunya, he was calling ummati, ummati, my ummah, my ummah. My people, in his last moments in this dunya, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his first concern was about the ummah. He said that ana sayyid al-nas yawm al-qiyamah wa la faqat. Why do we send salutations upon the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Why? We will know why. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said ana sayyid al-nas yawm al-qiyamah. I'll be the leader of people in the day of judgment. The sahaba radhiyallahu anhum, they asked how? He told them on the day of judgment, when the people or the anxiety or the anguish or the wrath of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the day of judgment, they shall not be able even to stand. And they look at each other, what do we do? And they will say to each other, let's go to Adam. And they go to Adam alayhi salam, and they say, Ya Adam, anta al-abu al-bashar, O Adam, you are the father of the mankind. And you, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created you with his own hand. Ishfa' lana ila rabbi. Don't you see in what trouble we are? Intercede for us to your Lord. He will say, nafsi, nafsi. I'm concerning only about myself today. Nafsi, nafsi. اذهبوا الى غيري, go to see someone else. Then they will go to Nuh alayhi salam. And they will tell him, you are the first prophet on the earth. Ishfa' lana ila rabbik, intercede for us to your Lord. He will say, nafsi, nafsi. I'm only concerned about myself. The same thing, they will go to Ibrahim. He will tell them the same thing. Go see somebody else. And they will go to Isa. And they will tell them the same. He will tell them the same thing. And they will go to Musa alayhi salam. Or they go to Musa and they go to Isa, and they will tell them the same thing. And they will tell them, go and see Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And when they see sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when they go to him, and they tell him, you are the final messenger, the last messenger of Allah, and you are the beloved one of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ishfa' lana ila rabbi, intercede for us to your Lord. He will say, ana laha, I'm here for you, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Once sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was sitting with Aisha radiallahu anha, and she said, I saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a good mood to see. I was worrying about the ummah. Yet when we hear his best name, some of us, they can't say even sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To see how he was worried about the ummah, he wants Aisha radiallahu anha, and she said, I saw the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a good mood. Then I said, let me take advantage of this, and let me ask him for a dua. And she asked him for a dua, and he said, Allahumma akhfir li Aisha ma qaddamat wa ma akharat. Oh Allah, forgive Aisha the previous sins and the future sins. And Aisha radiallahu anha, she was so happy with the dua. She was so happy with the dua. And he asked her, are you happy? She said, yes, I'm happy. Definitely I'm happy with the dua. He said, wallahi, this is my dua for my ummah in every salah. In every salah. Once Jibril alayhi salam came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam and he told him, Ya Muhammad, O Muhammad, Allah is telling you to command your ummah to read the Quran on one mode. One mode, inshallah, will explain this in the coming Jumu'ahs. In one mode, one half. Then he says, Ya Allah, inna ummati la tatiqu dhalik, that my ummah has not strength to do so. Make it easy on my ummah. Then he told him, okay, let them read it with two modes. He said, Ya Allah, inna ummati la tatiqu dhalik, that my ummah has no strength to do so. Oh Allah, make it easy on my ummah. Then he told him, let them read it with the three modes. He said, Ya Allah, my ummah cannot do so, has no strength to do so. Until he told him, let them read it with seven modes. And any of these modes, whichever mode they read with it, the Quran, then they will be correct. And in the end of the hadith, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَإِنِّي دَعُوتُ اللَّهَ لِخِرْ أُمَّ لِأُمَّتِي. He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive his ummah. And he asked him twice, اللهم اغفر لأمتي اللهم اغفر لأمتي و الله forgive my أمة و الله forgive my أمة. And he said in the third one, I kept it for the day of judgment. And he said, إن لكل نبي دعوة. For every prophet, he has a special invocation, a special dua. And he was granted this dua in his life. ودخلت دعوتي لأمتي يوم القيامة. And I kept my special education as an intercession for the day of judgment for my ummah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Once, to see how he was loving us. Once, he was in a graveyard with the sahaba, radiallahu anhum, and he told them, وَدَدْتُ لَوْ أَنَّ رَأَيْنَا إِخْوَانَا. I wish if you would see our brothers. Then they asked him, oh, the Prophet of Allah, are we not with your brothers? He said, no, you are my companions, but my brothers are those who will come after me. They believe in me while they didn't see me. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To see the effort, the concern, the worry of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to his ummah. This is why now we understand why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Al-Bakhilu man dhukirtu indahu wa lam yusalli alayhi, that the miser person is the one in his presence. I'm mentioned and yet didn't say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first thing sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he is out of his grave, the first thing, ummati, ummati. In the day of judgment, now you do whatever. And in the day of judgment, will be your intercessor. Oh Allah, don't punish him. He is one of my followers. So sending salawat on the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is very important. As it comes in the hadith, especially in the day of Jumu'ah. It comes in the hadith that inna afdala ayyamikum yawm al-jumu'ah. That the first of your days is the day of Jumu'ah. فيه خلق آدم, Adam was created this day. وفيه مات, Adam died on this day. And also the chant will be blown on this day. And the creations will swarm in this day. And this day the doors of Jannah will be open. And he said, if you can make a great deal with sending me salutations, invoking a blessing upon me, then do it. فَإِنَّ أَعْمَالَكُمْ مَعْرُوضَةٍ عَلَيْهِ, that your salutations will be shown to me. The Sahaba رضي الله عنهم, they said, how will our salutations or our blessings be shown to you when you turn into a dust? He said, إِنَّ اللَّهَ حَرَّمَ الْأَرْضَ عَلَىٰ. He said, the Anbiya, that Allah has forbidden the earth to consume the bodies of the prophets. اللهم صلى وسلم على نبينا محمد وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين.
الله أكبر الله